Welcome friends, let us go for the carbides and the nitrides of the boron family. Boron family elements eligible for a discussion are boron as well as the aluminium. This boron and aluminium on heating with charcoal carbon combines with the carbon. As a result, they forms carbides because carbon is maintaining higher electronegativity compared to the boron. Hence, as being carbon is having relatively higher electronegativity, the chemical combination of third year group elements with the carbon are said to be the carbides. So therefore, boron combination with carbon gives boron carbide, that is B4C, whereas aluminium on combination with carbon gives aluminium carbide, Al4C3. Boron carbide is covalent in nature and it is very hard material, generally used for cutting of diamonds and making holes in the rocks. Whereas aluminium carbide is not covalent, it is ionic compound. Aluminium is having plus 3 units of positive charge, whereas carbon is having plus 4 units of minus 4 units of negative charge. It is ionic compound, it participates in hydrolysis, and as a result of hydrolysis it produces methane. Hence this aluminium carbide is said to be methanoid. Methanoid is that compound which produces methane and hydrolysis. Hence here Al4C3 on reaction with water, the corresponding oppositely charged radicals combines with the counter radicals of the water. As a result, aluminium results into aluminium hydroxide and the C-4 results into CH4, that is methane formation occurs. Hence it is said to be methanoid. Nitrides, similar to that of the carbides, boron and aluminium readily combines with the atmospheric nitrogen or the ammonia gas. As a result of the reaction which is occurring at high temperature, boron combination with nitrogen gives boron nitride, BN, whereas aluminium combination with nitrogen gives aluminium nitride. And aluminium nitride formation also occurs in the surfex process, whereas in surfex process, alumina on reaction with nitrogen gas in presence of charcoal leads to the formation of aluminium nitride followed by carbon monoxide. Whereas this nitride, boron nitride as well as the aluminium nitride, both participates in hydrolysis. As a result of hydrolysis, here nitrogen is having relatively higher electronegativity compared to the third year group elements. And in water, H plus is the positive radical, OH minus is the negative radical. Counter radicals combines with one another. As a result, it leads to the formation of boron hydroxide, BOH3, which is known as boric acid, followed by ammonia. Similarly here, aluminium hydroxide followed by ammonia gas formation occurs. Thus here, nitrides, both boron and aluminium, combines with atmospheric nitrogen or ammonia and produces nitrides, which is possible at high temperature. Boron followed by nitrogen, boron nitride. Aluminium followed by nitrogen, aluminium nitride. Similarly, alumina on reaction with nitrogen followed by carbon leads to the formation of aluminium nitride followed by carbon monoxide, which is a gas which increases entropy of the process. As a result, delta G becomes negative and process occurs in the forward direction. Whereas boron nitride as well as aluminium nitride undergoes hydrolysis. As a result of hydrolysis, here boric acid followed by ammonia, aluminium hydroxide followed by ammonia gas formation occurs. Yes, oxides of the boron family. There are two important oxides with respect to the important elements. Those are boron oxide as well as the aluminium oxide. Boron oxide is B2O3, aluminium oxide is alumina, Al2O3 we can say. Whereas formations of B2O3, boron on reaction with oxygen forms boron oxide. Similarly, boric acid on heating, elimination of water takes place and leads to the formation of boron oxide. Here there is no change in oxidation number since it is non-redox reaction. Whereas this is a redox reaction. Similarly, boron on reaction with the non-metal oxides like carbon dioxide, silicon dioxide, nitric oxide, where boron is acting as good reducing agent, it reduces carbon dioxide to carbon, silica to silicon, and nitric oxide to nitrogen. In this process, boron is converted as boron oxide. Similarly, boron not readily combines with the water, but on reaction with red hot boron on reaction with steam, it leads to the formation of boron oxide followed by hydrogen. Similarly, borax on heating, elimination of water takes place, anhydrous borax formation occurs. Still on heating, it is converted to sodium metaborate followed by what? Boron trioxide formation occurs. And here the properties, if you look at boron trioxide on reaction with the metals like sodium, potassium as well as magnesium, it leads to the formation of boron followed by metal oxides like sodium oxide, potassium oxide, magnesium oxide formation occurs. And boron on reaction with aluminum leads to the formation of boron oxide on reaction with aluminum leads to the formation of boron followed by alumina. And here almost all, if it is allowed to react with the molten situation of alumina, crystals of boron formation occurs. And boron oxide on reaction with water, boric acid formation takes place. Hence this boron oxide is known as anhydride of boric acid. Similarly, in borax bead test also, the material that is used is boron oxide, whereas boron oxide in reaction with metal oxides, it leads to the formation of metal borates, which are having their perfect colors for the identification, and the metal is present in plus 2 oxidation state. Here chromium borate is having green color, manganese borate is having violet color, ferrous borate is having yellow color. Similarly, cobalt borate is having blue color, nickel borate is having violet color, and copper borate is having green color. It is also easy to remember, top and bottom are having green, next are having violet, and between two, yellow as well as the blue. Here, chromium, manganese, ferrous, cobalt, nickel, copper, all are present, the six elements are present in continuation. This is nothing but what? Boron oxide, that is B2O3. The structure of B2O3 is B2O3 structure, boron-boron connected with the oxygen followed by every boron atom is connected with the double bonded oxygen, and the structure of boron oxide is like this. This is boron oxide. Alumina, Al2O3. Al2O3 is available in many varieties of forms. Al2O3 without having water is said to be the corundum. Al2O3, 1H2O is said to be the diaspar, and 2H2O is said to be the dihydrate, and 3H2O is said to be the gibbsite. These are the different varieties of forms of alumina oxide that is said to be alumina. Whereas preparation of alumina, Al2O3, can be done. Aluminium on reaction with oxygen leads to the formation of aluminium oxide formation. This is redox reaction. Whereas aluminium hydroxide on heating, dehydration takes place, elimination of water takes place, and that leads to the formation of alumina, Al2O3 followed by water, non-redox reaction. Similarly, aluminium nitrate also on heating leads to the formation of alumina. Oxidation state of aluminium is maintained as it is. So therefore, here this particular nitrate of plus 5 state is converted to nitrogen dioxide, underwent reduction. Hence, counterly oxidation should present, that is, some portion of oxygen of minus 2 is converted to oxygen 0, O2 is liberated. These are the preparation methods, general preparation methods. In some other reactions also we can find alumina. Suppose the less electropositive metal oxides on reaction with aluminium, aluminium is acting as good reducing agent. It reduces chromium oxide to chromium followed by formation of alumina. Similarly, this is said to be the aluminothermit process. Ferric oxide is converted to ferrous followed by Al2O3. Similarly, Mn3O4 is converted to manganese. Even not only the less electropositive metal oxides, non-metal oxides also on reaction with aluminium are converted to alumina followed by corresponding non-metals, like carbon dioxide is converted to carbon followed by Al2O3. Silicon dioxide is converted to silica followed by Al2O3. Other methods of preparation, even aluminium sulphate on heating leads to the formation of alumina followed by sulphur trioxide. Similarly, ammonium alum, ammonium sulphate, aluminium sulphate 24H2O on heating leads to the formation of Al2O3, ammonia, sulphur trioxide as well as the water molecules. And at the same time, aluminium fluoride on reaction with boron trioxide leads to the formation of boron trifluoride followed by Al2O3 formations. These are the preparation methods of Al2O3. Yes, depending upon the mode of preparation of alumina, alumina is existing in many crystalline forms. The important crystalline forms are alpha as well as the beta. Alpha corundum, that is alpha Al2O3, this is hard, stable at high temperature, resistant to hydration, and it is not attacked by acids and used as abrasive and is known as what? Corundum. Similarly, beta form of Al2O3 is this is activated form of alumina. It is not maintaining such kind of corundum related conditions and it is actively participates in chemical transformations. Whereas crystalline Al2O3 is a constituent of many of the stones like ruby, sapphire, topaz, is consisting some impurity associated with Al2O3. The different impurities present in alumina offers different colors, but every particular variety of ruby, sapphire, topaz, that is costly stones, are consisting of Al2O3. Yes, similar to that of the boron, remaining elements also on combination with oxygen forms the corresponding oxides like boron oxide, aluminium oxide, gallium oxide, indium oxide, as well as the thallium oxide also. The trend related to their property, if we observe, the acidic properties goes on decreasing. That is, their basic nature is goes on increasing. Boron oxide is acidic in nature, whereas aluminium and gallium are amphoteric in nature. Indium and thallium oxides are strongly basic in nature. Thus, we can confirm that one also, acidic nature of B2O3. B2O3 and reaction with base, sodium metaborate formation takes place. Whereas, Al2O3 and reaction with acids as well as bases, it forms the compounds. Because it is having amphoteric nature, thus it combines with both acids as well as the bases. Al2O3 and reaction with HCl, aluminium chloride formation takes place. And reaction with base, similar to this one, metal aluminate, that is sodium metal aluminate formation also takes place. Thus it is having amphoteric nature and these are having acidic nature. Thus acidic nature is goes on decreasing from top to bottom in the case of boron oxides. Yes, boron hydroxides. Out of the hydroxides, boron hydroxide is important. Boron hydroxide, that is BOH3, whereas it is prepared by the hydrolysis of boron oxide. Boron oxide and reacts with water gives the boron hydroxide BOH3. Boron trihydroxide dissolves in water to give different varieties of boric acids. One is orthoboric acid, that is BOH3, that is H3BO3, that is B2O3 followed by 3 water molecules combination. Similarly, metaboric acid, HBO2 formation occurs. HBO2 is nothing but B2O3 followed by 1 water molecule. And tetraboric acid, which is also known as pyroboric acid, that is H2B4O7, that is 2 B2O3 molecules are having 1 water molecule. Thus, depending on the reaction condition, different varieties of boric acids are prepared. The foremost important boric acid is four most important acids of boron is orthoboric acid, that is BOH3, and the preparations of BOH3 can be done from the borax. Borax is sodium salt of boron oxides, so therefore it is having basic nature. This on reaction with water, this on reaction with the acid, aqueous hydrolysis, acidification of borax by using aqueous HCl solution, it leads to the formation of salt, sodium chloride followed by boric acid formation occurs. Similarly, the borax on reaction with aqueous sulfuric acid also leads to the formation of sodium sulfate followed by boric acid formation occurs. And followed by the hydrolysis reactions of the corresponding boron and the more electronegative compounds like boron nitride, boron chloride, similarly diborane as well as boron sulfides on reaction with water undergoes hydrolysis. As a result of hydrolysis, they produces the corresponding orthoboric acid. Boron chloride and reaction with water undergoes hydrolysis, it gives orthoboric acid followed by HCl. Diborane and reaction with water gives the corresponding boron trihydroxide, that is orthoboric acid followed by hydrogen gas is liberated. Boron nitride and hydrolysis gives boric acid followed by ammonia gas is liberated. Boron sulfide and reaction with water, boric acid followed by H2S, that is hydrogen sulfide formation takes place. These are preparation methods of important acid of boron, that is known as orthoboric acid, with the formula BOH3. Yes, are the boric acid can also prepare from the calamanite, similar to that of the borax, that is Ca2B6O11, and reaction with sulfur dioxide followed by the water, it leads to the formation of calcium bisulfite followed by boric acid formation takes place, and here there is no change in oxidation numbers of any of the components, hence it is a non-redox reaction. The structures of boron hydroxides, here I am writing the molecular structures first. That is orthoboric acid BOH3, boron is sp2 hybridization planar, and it is connected with the 3 OHs with an angle of 120 degrees each, whereas metaboric acid, which is consisting less number of water molecules, whereas this metaboric acid is consisting one OH connectivity to the boron, and the another one is double bond O connectivity, and next one is pyroboric acid, otherwise the tetraboric acid, and in this what happens is 2 boron units combination is present in the form of a ring, and these two boron atom connectivities, two boron atoms containing two rings are connected with the oxygen as a common position. So therefore this is two borons, two oxygens, four membered ring, two borons, two oxygens, four membered ring connected with a common oxygen, just like pyro and hydride like system, and here it is connected with one OH, here also it is connected with the another one OH, it is said to be the tetraboric acid, because total four borons are there, and it is present in the form of just like anhydride and also known as what, pyroboric acid. Structure of orthoboric acid. Orthoboric acid is having a layer structure, and here in the plane BO3 3 minus units are present and are joined by the hydrogen bonds. Hydrogen at some portions forms the regular connectivity with the oxygen of the same boric acid molecule, and also involves in hydrogen bond with the other molecule of the boric acid. These layers are quite large distance apart, maintaining a distance of 3.18 angstrom units. Thus crystal breaks quite easily into very fine particles. Whereas the boric acid structure, molecular structure, if I consider single molecule is like this. Now let us go for the hydrogen bonds representation in the case of the orthoboric acid. This is regular single molecule of boric acid. Now we will construct the arrangement of other boric acids in association with this boric acid, where the hydrogen bonds and the size of the ring is going to be maintained. Each molecule of boric acid is planar and having bond angle of 120 degrees and with the hybridization of sp2, whereas this is the molecule of boric acid I wrote in the beginning, and another molecule of boric acid and the boric acid molecules are present, whereas these are connected in such a way that, see here, one of the boric acids oxygen and the other boric acid hydrogen is involved in hydrogen bonding. This is the hydrogen bond. Similarly, here also hydrogen bond, and here hydrogen bond is present between these two. Here also hydrogen bond. And here hydrogen bond. Here also hydrogen bond is present. And if you go for this, here hydrogen bond is present. Thus, here ring formation occurs. If you look at the ring system, this is boron followed by 2 oxygens, 3, boron followed by 2 oxygens, another 3. In the middle, you are having the hydrogens. Total 8 membered ring structure formations occurs here or there. Thus, as a layer, it extends from one end to other end. Such kind of structure is present for the orthoboric acid. The layered structure of orthoboric acid consisting of, this is boric acid units, 6 units are connected in such a way that, here see, if I take one boric acid, here one oxygen, one oxygen, one oxygen, one oxygen, one oxygen, all oxygens are present towards the core connected with the alternative hydrogen bonds. This hydrogen is regular OH bond, this is hydrogen bond, whereas its hydrogen is involved in hydrogen bond, whereas this OH is regular and this OH bond is hydrogen bond. Like this, all oxygens connected hydrogens are involved in hydrogen bond at the interior, whereas at the outer portion of the ring system, see, for every one boric acid molecule, two OHs are involved. But here, per molecule, one hydrogen bond is necessary. So therefore, one H is involved as regular bond. Another is connected with the hydrogen bond, and it is having free OH. It involves with the hydrogen bond with the other molecule. Similarly, within the outer ring, here this is regular OH. So therefore, this will be the hydrogen bonding, and this is regular OH in place. This will be the hydrogen bonding. In that way, outer circle is also going to be formed, and these are involved in the hydrogen bonding with the other molecules. Next layer is going to be formed. Thus, such kind of structure is present for the boric acid in the form of layer from one end to the other end. Yes, orthoboric acid is a white crystalline substance, and it is soft and soapy in touch. It is moderately soluble in cold water but fairly soluble in hot water, whereas it is steam volatile in nature. It is weak monobasic acid, however it differs from the normal monobasic acids. Monobasic acids are those substances which will generally donate the proton, but here it differs from the protonic acids. It not on its own donates the proton. On reaction with water, it takes up the hydroxyl group. As a result, it is acting as a proton donor. That is, it is acting as a Lewis acid because it is having vacant orbitals. It is electron deficient compound. So therefore, boric acid on reaction with water, due to having of vacant orbital, it can take up the OH minus radical, OH minus ion. As a result, it is converted to BOH4 minus, thus H plus is donated. Thus it is acting as monobasic acid. For our easiness of understanding, on reaction with the two molecules of water, it is converted to BOH4 minus followed by H3O plus. On behalf of this reaction, it is electron deficient, it is acting as Lewis acid, and it is acting as monobasic acid. Though it is consisting three OHs groups, it is not donating any proton from that. It is acting as monobasic acid, non-protonic monobasic acid, whereas the proton donated from it is not from the exactly from the boric acid, it is from the water molecule. Since boric acid is weak acid, it can't be titrated with the sodium hydroxide, because sodium hydroxide reaction with the boric acid doesn't give satisfactory because no sharp end point is detected, because the amount of H plus liberated is not constant. But in case of addition of any of the polyhydroxy compounds such as glycerol, mannitol, sugar, glycols, those of all are 6 diols, then boric acid behaves as a strong monobasic acid. Because here what happens is, in presence of water, as it acting as Lewis acid, take up the OH and it is converted to BOH4 minus followed by H plus. That maintains an equilibrium. In presence of polyhydroxy compounds, here I am taking an example of 1,3-diol. 1,3-diol is polyhydroxy. Because it is single bond, you can consider as cis trans, no issue, everywhere it works. So therefore, it and here BOHs and the OHs, elimination of water molecule takes place. Thus, one molecule of 1,3-diol reacts with the two OH groups present in the BOH4, thus forms a ring system over here, another ring system over here. In this process, elimination of water takes place. Thus, whatever the BOH4 minus is formed, that is consumed over here, thus reaction moves in the forward direction, and the maximum amount, 100% of monoprotonic acid type, 100% of H plus is liberated, equivalent of H plus is liberated. Thus, maximum amount of H plus is liberated implies, in presence of this particular polyhydroxy compounds, boric acid is acting as strong acid, and that liberated anionic compound readily combines with the sodium, and the H plus readily combines with the OH ion present in the sodium. Thus, it leads to the formation of salt followed by sodium salt of this one, and it can be detected with the help of phenolphthalein indicator. Thus, in presence of polyhydroxy compounds or 6-diol like substances, in presence, boric acid is acting as strong acid, strong monobasic acid. Let us go for the reaction. What happens when this boric acid is allowed to react with the sodium hydroxide in the presence of polyhydroxy compounds? Boric acid on reaction with water, that is borate, BOH4- followed by H+ ion formation occurs, that maintains an equilibrium, that is a reversible reaction. Thus, the formed BOH4- ion in presence of diols, cis diols, combines and forms a complex, stable complex with elimination of water. From here OH, from here H, from here OH, from here H. Thus, two molecules of water, four molecules of water elimination takes place. See here, in this formation, one water, second, third, and the four molecules of water elimination takes place. Thus, it leads to the formation of a complex anion followed by water molecule. And thus, BOH4- concentration decreases. It allows the reaction to occur in the forward direction. Thus, every BOH3 is consumed and it is converted to corresponding H+. Thus, now we are having 100% of this anion followed by H+. This on reaction with sodium hydroxide. Sodium combines with this, forms a complex. Hydroxide combines with H+, forms water molecule. As concentration of sodium hydroxide increases, free OH- concentration increases and is detected by the indicator added phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein detects the excess concentration of OH- when it enters into the basic medium, it will be detected and color change will occur. Thus, we can identify the color change and we are making that boric acid as strong acid in presence of polyhydroxy compounds. Yes, reactions with strong alkali. Boric acid on reaction with strong alkali like sodium hydroxide solution, it leads to the formation of sodium borate, NaBOH4-. That is, sodium hydroxide is imbibed by the boric acid because it is electron deficient. It can take the OH-. As a result, the formed anion combines with the sodium cation, NaBOH4- is formed. This on heating loses water molecules and it is converted to metaborate, that is sodium metaborate, because the formed sodium borate is unstable, having more than 3-4 OHs are there, elimination of water molecule takes place. By elimination of 2 molecules of water here, it is converted to BO2-. That BO2- is counterbalanced by sodium and leads to the formation of sodium metaborate. Heating effect. Boric acid undergoes heating effect at temperature of 100 degree centigrade, it is converted to metaboric acid. This metaboric acid and heating at 160 degree centigrade once again loses some quantity of water molecule and it is converted to tetraboric acid, otherwise the pyroboric acid, having formula H2B4O7. Thus, once again on heating more than 160 degree centigrade, whatever the water quantity is there, total water quantity left from the system and is converted to boron trioxide, that is B2O3. Let us observe this particular relation in the form of a logic. We are having different varieties of boron, oxygen and the hydrogen combinations. One is boric acid, metaboric acid, pyroboric acid followed by boron trioxide, that is B2O3. Whereas here in this, the number of water molecules and the boron trioxide combination, logically if we go, here for one boric acid, one boron trioxide, that is 2 times of this one, 6 oxygens implies 3 water molecules are there. Whereas in metaboric acid, that is HBO2, that is if I take boron trioxide B2O3, then 2 H2Os implies what, 1:1 ratio of water and the B2O3 is present. Whereas in pyroboric acid H2B4O7, so therefore there are 2 boron trioxides and the 1 water molecule is there. Whereas in just boron trioxide, only boron trioxide is there is no water. If you look at 100 degree centigrade, from relatively 1:3 ratio is converted to 1:1 ratio. Whereas at 160 degree centigrade, this will be converted to 1:0.5 ratio. And more than 160 degree centigrade, it is converted from this particular ratio to 1:0 ratio of boron trioxide as well as the water. Thus, at 100 degrees it forms metaboric acid. At 160 degrees it forms tetraboric acid, otherwise the pyroboric acid, which is having less quantity of water. And still on heating red hot, then the tetraboric acid is converted to without water containing anhydrous form of the boric acid, that is nothing but what? Boron trioxide formation takes place, that is B2O3. Uses of boric acid. Boric acid solution is weak antiseptic for eyes, which is known as boric lotion. boric lotion, whereas used as enamel and the glass industry and the pottery glazes, as a food preservative in the food industry and in the manufacturing of pigments as well as the borax in making of borosilicates. Similar to boric acid, aluminium hydroxide are also present, and this is known as aluminium hydroxide only, AlOH3. Aluminium hydroxide can be prepared from the aluminium chloride. Aluminium chloride, non-anhydrous aluminium chloride, that is AlCl3 6H2O. Thus, on heating, this AlCl3, as being electron deficient compound, undergoes hydrolysis with its water of crystallization and leads to the formation of aluminium hydroxide. Aluminium nitride on reaction with water undergoes the hydrolysis and leads to the formation of ammonia followed by aluminium hydroxide. And sodium meta-aluminate, which is formed as a product in the reaction sequence of extraction of, that is concentration of aluminium in Bayer's process, Hall's process and the Surfex process. This on reaction with carbon dioxide and the water, sodium carbonate and the aluminium hydroxide formation takes place. Similarly, alumina on reaction with sodium hydroxide, that is converted to sodium aluminate. The sodium aluminate on reaction with air water undergoes water-related hydrolysis and leads to the formation of sodium hydroxide followed by aluminium hydroxide formation. Whereas heating effect, aluminium hydroxide strong heating about more than 1200 degrees centigrade. All water molecules will be eliminated and it is converted to anhydrous alumina Al2O3. Reaction with base, AlOH3, on reaction with the strong bases like sodium hydroxide, it leads to the formation of sodium meta aluminate. Whereas aluminium hydroxide is insoluble, but on reaction with sodium hydroxide, it forms a strongly ionizable ionic compound of sodium and the aluminium oxide combination, is known as sodium meta aluminate, which is soluble in water. These are the properties related to the aluminium hydroxide. And aluminium hydroxide is having use in the medicines as to remove the pain in the burning sensation in the heart and to remove the burning sensation in the gastric problems and the stomach related burning situations, as an anti-ulcer drug, and also in curing of the healing of the sore related, stomach, intestine related sores can be stopped by the aluminium hydroxide because it is acting as weak base.